Good afternoon. We are here in the center of Zagreb on a very beautiful sunny day with Mr. Abhishek Kumar Sharma, a world traveler from India on a very special tour with a very special mission. Hello, Mr. Sharma.
Namaste.
Namaste.
Yeah.
Can you please tell us a little bit about the reason of your coming to Zagreb, Croatia?
I'm doing world tour on bicycle. I'm a researcher and I'm raising awareness for climate change and global warming. On the other hand, I'm spreading a message of peace, message of harmony, message of friendship. So this is a friendship tour between India and Croatia. So I started from India, this campaign, and I am visiting entire world, India to India, around the globe, approximate 80 to 90 countries, 95,000 kilometers bicycling, and 6 continents and 6 years. So I started 10th November 2014, so almost 2 years is gonna complete. And this Croatia is my 27th country, and the Zagreb is my 614th city and town. So almost 2 years I'm doing this. I'm meeting people, doing interaction, visiting institutions like universities and colleges, and Indian embassies, and the local people, local government people I'm visiting. The local people are supporting me around the globe. On the other hand, this is a world campaign, and I'm doing this as a global citizen for betterment of the planet, for betterment of the mankind, for betterment of the society. Because I believe in my heart that entire world is a family. We have an Indian culture. We called it Vasudeva Kutumbakam. It means entire world is a family. So we all have some social responsibilities for betterment of this planet as a global citizen. So I am serving my moral responsibilities as a global citizen. So I believe that Croatia is my home. I believe that entire world is my home. So I don't have any fear. I don't have any hesitation. I'm walking, I'm doing the bicycling, I'm also walking. So people are always coming, they said, "Wow, whatever you are doing, you are world tour and sort of thing." People like, I'm holding the country flag, which country I'm riding with my country flag, and this is the entire setup I have. So like these things are happening. I have sleeping bag, tent, my food, and the thing is that I'm also practicing yoga. I'm practicing yoga since 4 years, and I'm vegetarian, I'm 100% vegetarian. And this is the secret of my energy, actually. And people are also giving me energy when they smile, when they talk, when they laugh with me. It gives me energy to do 100 and 100 kilometers more and more. And so far I have done 32,400 kilometers. So you can imagine like that.
I can imagine.
So it's a global campaign. And this campaign is, I'm doing this campaign because of the people, because of the local people. Everywhere people are supporting me for food, for accommodation, for financial, because it's a people's funded program. So I'm doing this for the betterment of the people's societies, for people's mankind, actually. Yes.
How do you, how are you satisfied with your acceptance here in Croatia? You mentioned you really like Croatian energy.
Yeah, I can say one tagline for Croatia: beautiful country with beautiful people.
Thank you.
The people are very beautiful here. Beautiful, like they're very supportive, very generous, and I felt that there is a connection between India and Croatia. So here, yeah, this is the very good opportunity for me as a world traveler to came here to learn from them, from the people, from the culture, from the everything. The architecture is very good. Now today is the very sunny day, so
it's
like
a beautiful
this
day.
Yeah,
so please tell me, what is the procedure when you come to a new country? What do you do first? Do you speak to the authorities? Do you go to a college, university? What is your main target, and what do you wish to achieve mostly?
My first target is Indian embassies and local people. Local people are my strength. So when I entered into the city or country, I connect contact with the local people, and they tell me about the city, the people, the country, the culture, the tradition, the geographical area, the weather condition, the place to visit, like a tourist place or something like, or they connect to me to other people, like universities and institutions, like local people also. So like this, it's like a collective approach, inclusive approach, integrated approach from the people to me, And because I'm very attractive, my bicycle is attractive, so people are, I'm attracting people and they are coming, they are asking, and I'm giving the answer of them. So like these things are happening. So it's like a complete package, complete package of many things.
Do you hold lectures or seminars?
Yeah, I'm conducting some lectures and seminars also. The future consequences of climate change and global warming. Why the these things are, we need to discuss these all things. And this is the only time to do, to act for this concern. So this is like, I can say, this is very important. Very, very important for us as a human being. Because if we will do the right step right now, then the, we can save the nature and the planet. Otherwise, the future will be very worst. So I came here to aware people, to educate people, to motivate people that this is the only time to act for climate change and global warming. And on the other hand, we help, we should help each other. This is a big planet. We don't need any war. We don't need any hate. We don't need any racism. This is a planet. We are the, we all are a family. We need to help each other. We need to spread the smile. We need to spread the positivity around the globe. This is what I need. So I need the peace around the world. That's why I'm doing this.
That is a very beautiful message. Can you see an impact, a result on countries that you visited?
Yeah, yeah. The, you know, the initiative starts from the people. There are 7.4 billion population around the globe. And if we people, the human being, want a better future for our children, for our generations, then we need to do, we need to act right now. So like I'm promoting bicycling, like bicycling is an eco-friendly way. I'm promoting green practices. I'm promoting eco-friendly practices. So these practices we will do, the people, not the government. Government is also, you know, it's a system and we are the part of this system. So we have to, first of all, you know, people are doing car and sort of thing. We don't need like a, we as much as possible we have to use the public transport, and as much as possible we have to do this bicycling, because it don't emit any kind of pollution. It's a very, very healthier exercise for mental mind and the for the physique. On the other hand, it saves the environment also, and no traffic with bike. So the situation is very worse, trust me.
Perfect.
In the big cities, everywhere traffic, pollution, so many things
especially
are there.
Especially in India, I guess.
Especially, we can say we are 1.3 billion population we have in India. So yeah, it's very crowded. But this problem is everywhere, not in India. Every country, they have different kind of situation. But the pollution is a big issue. Not in India, everywhere around the globe.
Is there any country you can say is specifically in a very bad condition because of climate change that you witnessed?
Yeah. I can say Maldives, Bangladesh, the coastal region of India, Bhutan. They didn't do anything, but they are facing this. Even the European countries also, the coastal countries. You know, the climate change is like this. See, if the temperature will rise, then ice cap will melt. Or if these ice cap will melt, the glaciers, then the sun, the ocean level, the water level of ocean, they will rise. Then it will create so many problems around the globe. Even the coastal cities, they will face so many natural disaster, and they are facing, many countries are facing. Even the Maldives, they are facing big problem. The Bangladesh, they are also, India also. And the most coastal, you can see that there are so many natural calamities are happening around the globe. Like somewhere earthquake, somewhere natural disaster, like forest fire, like somewhere flood, somewhere like drought, somewhere the weather changing, pattern changing. So like these things are happening around the globe. We can notice these all things. It's not a big, see, let me give the real example. This is 1st November in Croatia. It should be like a cold day here, but you can see it's like I think it's very sunny day here. This is a climate change actually. 10 years ago or 2 decades or 3 decades ago, it must be a snow here,
very cold. Yeah,
am I right or not?
Yes.
So this is the drawback of climate change. You know, in the winter season it's a very, very cold, and the summer season it's very, very, very hot. So it's, this is climate change actually. So this is, see, today is 1st November, we are in a capital city Zagreb. It's a very sunny day, it's like a, it's a hot day, but it's supposed to be a cold day.
And so this has been happening for how long now? When did you first become aware of the big issue of climate change?
It's like last few decades we are facing this problem. And if we will act like this, if we will think like economical growth, the people, the countries will think like, the government will think that mm-hmm. this is a economical growth, but this is not a economical growth. This is like a destruction, mm-hmm. destruction of climate, destruction of environment, the nature. And we are over exploiting the natural resources. That is why these all things are happening. Mm-hmm. We need to stop the over exploitation of natural resources. If the things will be like this, then the future, the big problem, the water problem, the food problem, because of if the weather pattern will change, the cultivation of food will change. So it will be a great problem for mm-hmm. food scarcity in future and water scarcity also in future. So we have to think like this right now. This is the act for change right now.
So what can we do exactly? I mean, on the level of authorities and governments, but on the second level of just a small individual who lives in a village in Croatia, what can he do to change this? Can one small change be enough?
Yeah, we can do lots of change. Like, first of all, we have to do bicycling.
Okay.
Because I am doing world tour. Bicycling is the best way to promote environment, to save the environment, mm-hmm. to save the thing it don't emit any kind of pollution and something like. So it's a first thing. Mm-hmm. Another thing, we can plant some trees around us, like 2-3. We can adopt 2-3 plants. I'm also, my target is 100,000 trees plantation. So
wow.
We can individually, we can do this.
Mm-hmm.
On the other hand, as much as possible, we can do the public transport and sort of thing. We don't need car and something like for the short distance. People are crazy. If they want to go 10 kilometers, they want to do car and sort of thing. We don't need it.
Mm-hmm.
On the other hand, the important thing, we can promote green practices like paper. It comes from the nature.
Mm-hmm.
Like electricity, it comes from also from nature. The thermal power plant, or the maybe from the hydropower plant, or maybe from the crude oil, this electricity is coming. So we have to, as much as possible, we can limited use these all kind of resources. So it will promote to save the environment.
Mm-hmm.
As an individual, we can do these things.
Mm-hmm. So basically, you are living proof for the idea, if you want to change the world, first start with yourself.
Exactly. Because the initiative starts from here. And first of all, we need to change the mindset up. Because the problem is here, around the globe.
Mm-hmm.
The materialistic approach, the thing like everything is economical growth is not like this. This planet is, trust me, this planet is very beautiful. And if we want to save this planet, we have to act right now.
Mm-hmm. And change starts with actions of just one person like you that will spread globally.
Exactly.
Can you please tell me, do you hope to inspire others like you to do the same, to go on a tour around the world and change the hearts and minds of people?
Of course. And see, when I'm doing that, people are coming, they are taking photo and they're asking me what you are doing. When I said that I'm promoting green practices, eco-friendly mm-hmm. practices, I'm raising awareness for climate change in global world, they said, wow, it's a good issue. People are aware about it actually. Everyone knows this. They need to start the act actually. They know
mm-hmm.
everything actually.
Mm-hmm.
Some people they don't know, but they are knowing because the thing is are changing around the globe.
Mm-hmm. So they just need a little bit of motivation.
Yeah,
so
they need motivation and awareness and education also.
So please tell me a little bit about your bicycle. This must be a very special bike because it's on the road for 2 years,
yeah,
right?
It's a
no
very
stopping, so 2 years away from home,
yeah,
together with your bike.
Yeah, so let me say, this is my third bike actually.
Mm-hmm.
And this is a very special bike. I got last month this bike in Lithuania. There is a Lithuanian company
wow.
called Baltic Garage. They
mm-hmm.
gave me this bike free. And it has a battery.
Mm-hmm.
And also this is very good for the environment. I'm not emitting any kind
mm-hmm.
of pollution, and it charges itself. There is a dynamo system.
Wow.
And I have a tent, sleeping bag, my vegetarian food, everything, the water, the batteries and everything. And when I found some problem, like yesterday I got problem with the stand, and
mm-hmm.
there is a company, very big company here, an organization called Kindle Sports,
mm-hmm.
and they supported me free of cost for this
wow.
stand. So
nice
everywhere
event.
People are also supporting me for bicycle repair, for tubes, tire and sort of things, bicycle accessories without money.
Wow. Wow, so you are giving a kindness, but you are receiving a lot of kindness.
Exactly, this is the bioverse concept.
Mm-hmm. So, what is your next stop? Which country?
Yeah, next country would be that Slovenia, mm-hmm. then Italy, then Switzerland, then France to England, then England to Ireland, then Ireland to France again by ferry, and then France to Spain, then Portugal, then Spain again, then southern part of Italy, and then southern part of Italy to America by flight, Montreal, and Montreal to New York, New York to Washington DC, Washington DC to across America, San Francisco, San Francisco to Mexico City, Mexico City to Guatemala, Honduras, Nicaragua, Panama, Costa Rica, Panama, then Panama to Venezuela, Colombia, Chile, Brasilia, Argentina, Paraguay and Argentina to flight South Africa, and South Africa to all the way Egypt, then Israel to Australia, then New Zealand, Papua New Guinea, Japan, the Fiji, Japan, Korea, China, Myanmar, and back to India in 2020.
Wow, my God,
yes.
So it's a very, very luxurious tour.
Yeah, it's...
Are you tired? I mean, how long do you stay in each country? Do you get enough rest or do you do a lot of sightseeing, I guess?
Yeah,
of
course.
You don't really stop much.
First of all, I'm not tired because this is my decision. Nobody instructing me to do this. This is my self-initiative as a global citizen. Mm-hmm. For betterment of this planet, so I'm not tired at all. One thing. Another thing is that I'm also visiting place, beautiful place, cities, monuments, and the museum also. Like these things are happening. Mm-hmm. And yeah, so everywhere is a good experience. I came here to learn a lot, to learn about the people, the culture, the food, the festivals, geographical area, language, weather condition, everything is unique.
Yes.
And this is my first visit in Croatia and mm-hmm. first visit in Europe. And it depends how much time I'm spent in a city or in a country, because some countries are big, some countries are small. Like Croatia is like not big country, but the small mm-hmm. countries, I'm going to spend here 7 days or 8 days, then I will be in different countries. So it depends on the area actually, what area mm-hmm. the country is holding, like this.
Once your tour is finished, do you plan to come back to Croatia? Do you like it?
Of course, I love this. It's a very, very good tourist destination. And mm-hmm. I have a tagline for Croatia, like a beautiful country with beautiful people.
Mm-hmm.
And seriously, it's a very beautiful tourist destination. People
Thank you.
must visit this country actually. The coastal region is very beautiful, like, mm-hmm. so yes, like
Thank
this thing.
You. How did you bring this decision to do this tour? Did you just wake up in the morning and say, I'm going on a tour around the world?
It's a very good question from you. Actually, I can say I really wanted to do when I was a child, to do something for this planet, for people. It was my dream to do something different in my life. That's why I'm holding backside from my bike. I wrote like this, one life, live it. So mm-hmm. there is only one life. And it depends on you, what you want. You want to make family, you want to earn money, you want to do job, or you want to do something different than others. It depends on you, what priority you have. My priority is do this, to do something different in life, something unique. Because I believe in my heart that there is only one life.
Mm-hmm.
And now it's depend you, on you, what you want to do.
Mm-hmm.
So different people, different kind of priorities. My priority is like I'm 28 right now. And my priority is like to visit entire world in one life. Every country, every culture, every capital city, every festival, food, geographical area, weather conditions, and people also. People are giving me motivation and inspiration
mm-hmm.
actually.
Beautiful.
The people's face, when we talk with the people, they don't know my language, I don't know their language, and we are talking in like small sentences. So it gives me energy, like the people are very good around the globe and their smile gives me energy actually, the face, their face.
Great.
Like this.
So what would be your message to Croatian people?
To Croatian people, I want to say that the good message is this, this entire world is a family.
Mm-hmm.
We should help each other. This is a planet for us and this is a very beautiful planet. Do travel around the globe. Spread the positivity around the globe, spread the love around the globe. This is the life only. It depends, do and die.
Very beautiful message. Thank you so much. We wish you a lot of luck on your future journey. Have a safe trip and we hope to see you back in Croatia
definitely,
after you
definitely.
Finish the trip.
Thank you so much.
Thank
Namaste.
You.